Today, we'll be showing you a guide to Zoho Project Timesheets, from setting it up to managing your timers. If you'd like to see more videos like this, subscribe to our channel and press that bell icon so you don't miss any update.
If you want to track time which was devoted for some tasks implementation in Zoho Projects, it is possible to do. You can do it in two ways. There is the possibility to log hours manually, or you can use timers. Let's set up timesheets before starting using such functionality. Go to Portal Configuration, Task and Timesheets, Timesheet Settings. Here you can customize everything as you want. There is the possibility to set time lock user restrictions. Now only task and issue owners can log hours under tasks to which they are set as owners. Also, you can set that anyone in project can log hours under all tasks under the project. Or only associated team members can log hours under related tasks. You have the ability to log hours for closed tasks and issues. You can allow or don't allow this, and you have the ability to allow or don't allow multiple timers. In the time lock configuration section, you can set only manual time lock input or only timer lock input. But in such case, it's better to use all. You can set time lock period settings and allow or don't allow logging past or future time. If you enable log hour limit, then you can set such daily or weekly limit, and if users' logs exceed the limit, the user won't be able to add more hours that is set in this limit. Concerning time log reminders, there is the possibility to set the amount of hours per day, and if hours are less than this stated amount, then the user will receive the daily reminder or weekly reminder. If you want to use timesheet approval process in Zoho Projects, then enable this checkbox and click Update. And also I want to emphasize that only admin users have the ability to approve timesheets. Let's run some tests to show you how this works. Let's start with timers. We are now at the task information section and on the task view. You can start timer by clicking on this clock button and the timer begins. You can pause this timer and add some notes or don't. Click Update. After that, the timer has saved some amount of hours or seconds in such case. And if you have closed the work on such task, then you can stop this timer at all. Here you can choose the type of the timer, whether it's billable or non-billable. After you clicked Update, we will refresh the page and scroll down the task information section, and in the Log Hours tab, we will see that there is the timer input here. And now this timer input is under pending status because it wasn't approved yet. Also, there is the possibility to log hours manually. And you can scroll down the task information section. There is the log hours tab and add time log button. Click on it and then define the information on the time log view. You can define the date. You can associate the user. You can choose the billing type of such time log, whether it's billable or non-billable, and enter the daily log. Let it be 1 hour. You can also add some notes and click Add. As you see, my manual log input was added under the Log Hours tab. As we are now under admin account, and under a test project, I, as admin, see that there is the notification on the timesheet tab. Let's go to this tab. And now I can see that there is only one approved timesheet and there are two new timesheets which are under pending status. I can approve one or reject one and add the note why the timesheet was rejected. Then there are also two possibilities to set up timesheet layouts. For example, as you see, when we are, for example, under some project that is associated to one billable layout and you add time lock, then the billing type is chosen as default. But also there are some projects which are associated to non-billable layout. And in such case, which when we add some time lock under some particular task, then this its billing type is by default non-billable. How we can define such setup? Let's go to the setup page and to customization section. Timesheets, layouts, and as you see, there are two layouts. One standard layout is for all billable projects, and this its billing type is chosen by default as billable. And also we can create layout by clicking on this button and copy this layout from the standard layout and then customize it for a little bit. And non-billable layout, as you see, its billing type is chosen as non-billable and its default option. And now under the standard layout, there is the associated project information. And we can check that, for example, Explore Zoho Projects, Print Projects, or Test 2 Project are associated to standard layout, which is billable. And only one test project is under non-billable. And that's why when we are under test project and we try to add some time lock, whether it's timer or manual, as you see, now we are under non-billable layout. And that's why this non-billable option is default and it's chosen without my choice. If I add manual input, once again, the billing type is non-billable. If we go, for example, to Sprints project, which is associated with the standard timesheet layout, and I want to add time lock, its billing type is billable. And we can check that now we are at the new time lock and it's under standard layout. In such case, if you have, for example, several projects which are billable and if you have some charity projects which are non-billable, then you can use timesheets layouts and billable or non-billable types will be chosen as default.
Thank you for watching our beginner's guide to Zoho Project Timesheets. Your continued support for our videos means a lot. Continue sharing our videos to your community, hit the like icon, and subscribe to our channel. For your other inquiries, you may reach us at knowhow@customization.ca.